So this session here is to try and get the students to think like an engineer. So they go through a creative design process, they then manufacture it, the sample, and then they go on to test and analyze how good that sample was. So they get a little bit of an idea about how industry is led by the components that they would put together and also the waste that could go on. But not only does it teach them about the manufacturing process, but it also teaches them about performance indexes, which are really important with understanding how materials get used in which applications. And this is something that we teach throughout the undergraduate degree. So students really enjoy this practical because it's really fun and engaging. It also teaches them how to work in a team and gives them a bit of creative flair within that. They also can then go on and learn how it feels to stand up in front of their peers and explain their research in a clear and articulate manner.
Today we produced a chocolate bar that was made up of loads of different materials, and the aim of the day was to make the toughest chocolate bar possible. In ours we put lasagna sheets, jelly sweets, which didn't really work, unfortunately they dissolved. And we layered those up in a sort of laminated structure in order to produce the toughest chocolate bar. We then came back later in the day to test this with the Sharpie machine, and we got a value of 8.15 for toughness.
Well, I'm really hoping that material science will give me the knowledge to take my career in lots of different directions and hopefully travel a lot as well, because I'd really like to see different countries, and I feel like with a degree with as diverse a range of topics covered as material science and engineering, I could work in a lot of different industries and countries.
I chose this course because I like the idea of aerospace, but a specialized subject which this focuses just on the materials. It's not aerospace engineering. And from what I've heard, the future of the aerospace industry is in materials. And Sheffield was the only university that offered this course. It was very unique, so there's no looking back.
I really enjoyed doing this session because it taught me skills that I wouldn't learn from lectures. It gave me an insight into the real world of engineering and made me consider things that, like I said, wouldn't be in my notes necessarily. The more time I spend here, the more I find that engineering's really a group process. People rarely design things on their own. They've always got a really good team behind them. And we've been set tutor groups, and this week we got the chance to really work closely with them.
The course is designed to give students the experience of working as a real materials engineer or materials scientist from day one. The practicals we do, the extended projects we do, get them working in that sort of frame. And so when the students finish the course, they're fully equipped to be a working materials scientist or materials engineer. People will go on and work in industry in many different levels, big multinationals or smaller startup companies, and other students will carry on and do further research degrees for qualifications such as a PhD.